morning, children. Good morning, everyone at home. Join us today again in our teens and Sunday school service. We are blessed to be here, and I hope you had a wonderful week. This is the day that the Lord has made, that we may rejoice in it. Join us this morning as we continue with our service, and we just want to remind ourselves of the memory verse last week. That is Luke 10:27. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your strength, and love your neighbor. I hope we went through the memory verse. Today we have Teacher Bridget. Teacher Bridget is our teacher, Madonye. That is a baby class and PP2. And also we have the teens group. Yay, let's appreciate them. And this morning we are going to be entertained. We are going to learn new songs. Stay, take your Bible, and feel most welcomed. Let us pray. Father, we thank you, we worship, and we glorify your name. Thank you for this moment that you have given us, Jehovah. Thank you for the gift of life, Jehovah. Thank you for the children who are joining us this morning, Jehovah. Daddy, we pray that they are going to get something this morning, Jehovah, that they will be blessed through the songs, Jehovah, through the dance, Jehovah, and even your word, my Father and my King. We honor you and we glorify your name, for it is in Jesus' name that we pray and believe. Welcome.
Forever and ever, forever and ever, forever and ever, Jesus. Jesus came down.
He came down from heaven.
When he landed.
Children, my name is Teacher Bridget, and today we are going to talk about a wonderful story about Jesus and Jesus walking on water. Jesus doing what, children? Jesus walking on water. And our message today is keeping our eyes on Jesus. Let's do it together. Keeping our eyes on Jesus. Now, a long, long time ago, Jesus and Peter walked on water. Now, children, can you be able to swim? Let's try it. Now, if you can be able to swim, that is very good. And can you be able to walk on water? Can someone tell me if they can be able to walk on water? Is that possible? No. Now, let me tell you a story. The disciples had a wonderful evening with Jesus. And Jesus had done wonderful miracles and amazing things to people. He had taught them. He was healing people. And he fed more than 500 people. More than what? 500 people. You know this story, children. He fed them with 5 loaves and 2 fish. How many loaves? 5 loaves and 2 fish. Now, when evening came, Jesus told the people to go home. And they did. But the disciples did not want to go home. They still wanted to stay with Jesus. But Jesus told them that they are supposed to go to the boat and cross the lake so that they can be able to go to Galilee. And Jesus went to rest so that he can be able to pray. How many of us pray? How do we pray? When I want to pray, I put my hands together, I close my eyes, I bow my head, and then I start to pray. And that is what Jesus did. Because Jesus knew that praying was very important. What was very important? Praying was very important. Now, as the disciples were on the boat, the rain started pouring down. Now, when it rains, what happens? You go and cover yourself. But the disciples did not have anywhere else to cover themselves. The boat did not have a roof on top of them. So they were struggling, and they were very cold, and they were very wet. Children, do you like it when you're wet? Oh, no, 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 no. Now, the disciples were wondering where the storm came from. There was a big storm. Now, let me show you a picture here. If you can see here, this is where it was raining, and you can see that there's there's a lake here and some fish, and it was raining very badly, and the disciples were very fearful. Now the word says, fear not, for I am with you, for I am with you. Now, shortly before it was morning, Jesus saw the disciples. Jesus saw the disciples, and he decided to walk towards them. To do what? To walk towards them. And while he was walking, the disciples saw something coming towards them. They were wondering, is it a fish? Is it a whale? Is it a man? They did not know. Was it a ghost? Oh my goodness. But Jesus said, it is I, Jesus. Do not be afraid. And Peter wondered. So Peter told Jesus, if it is truly you, Lord, call me. And Jesus called Peter. And Jesus said, come. Come to me. And Peter walked out of the boat and went to Jesus. And our message says, keep your eyes on Jesus. So while Peter was walking, look here, you can see Peter here. Peter was walking, and he walked majestically without fear, and he was courageous. Are you courageous, children? Yes. While you're swimming, you do not fear because you know you're not going to drown. But Peter was walking on water, and he was walking towards Jesus. Can you see him here? But something happened to Peter. He looked backwards where the disciples were. And when he was looking at them, he was like, oh, so I can walk on water. This is wonderful. But he forgot to put his focus on Jesus. Our message has said, keep your eyes on Jesus. So Peter stopped keeping his eyes on Jesus. And do you know what happened? He sank into the water and he started drowning. And he called onto the name of Jesus. Jesus, help me. Jesus, save me. And what did Jesus do? Jesus reached out his hand and lifted him up. And that is when Jesus told Peter, you of little faith, why did you doubt? Yeah? Peter was courageous, but when he looked backwards, he forgot to keep his eyes on Jesus. He forgot to keep his focus on who? On Jesus. But Jesus took Peter and went back to the boat. So when Jesus walked into the boat, it stopped raining, the clouds cleared, and the storm was over. Children, now if you look at our wonderful memory verse, it says, Luke chapter 18, verse 27, what is impossible with man is possible with God. Let us repeat it again. What is impossible with man is possible with God. And Jesus had faith that he was able to do anything, able to do anything. And that is what Peter had to do. He only had to have faith in Jesus and not to lose focus on Jesus. Now I'm going to teach you a wonderful song. Who was walking over the water? Who was walking over the water? Who was walking over the water? It's Jesus, the Son of God. Let's sing it in Kiswahili. Nani alitembea juu ya maji? Nani alitembea juu ya maji? Nani alitembea juu ya maji? Ni Yesu mwana wa Mungu. Let's sing it in Kikuyu. No waigerere igoro rwa mae. No waigerere igoro rwa mae. No waigerere igoro rwa mae. Ne Jesu mwana wa Ngai. And that is the end of our story. Be blessed.
I am down and all my soul.
done so much for me. I cannot tell it all. We say, if I had 10,000 tons, it still wouldn't be enough. Sing with me, say,
to remind you our memory verse for today. I hope you remember it, but I remind you it is from the book of Luke chapter 18 verse 27, and it says, anything that is impossible with man, it is possible with God. And let's bow our heads for a word of prayer. Mighty Father, we come before you, Lord, this
Wonderful day. Thanking you, Jehovah Lord, for this beautiful service that you've given unto us, Jehovah Lord. We thank you for everything that we have learned, Jehovah Lord, Abba Father. Thank you, Jehovah Lord, that we've experienced you, Jehovah Lord, Abba Father. I speak blessings, Jehovah Lord. I speak peace, love, and hope, Jehovah Lord, to all those that are watching, Abba Father. May you, Jehovah Lord, help them to know that, Jehovah Lord, everything is possible with you, Jehovah Lord. May you guide them even throughout the week, Jehovah Lord. Continue blessing them and guiding them, Jehovah Lord. Even for their parents, Jehovah Lord, may you bless them and guide them, Jehovah Lord. Even for our country, Jehovah Lord, may you continue being with it and helping us, Jehovah Lord, fight this corona, Jehovah Lord, Abba Father. We love you and we honor you, for it is in Jesus' name I pray and believe. Amen. I would also like to welcome you to our other services. I hope you enjoyed and you are blessed in the service. Amen. Bye.